see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Here we are at the 2017 Southern Colorado Sustainability Outdoor Expo, once again with Dome Creations and our guest Dave Falasco with his new and improved geodesic dome in the 24-foot version. Dave, you got to tell us how you got from where you were to where we are today.
Oh, I started back in the 80s making them out of wood, and today we're using aluminum extrusions, F-channel extrusion, installing polycarbonate panels, and we can bolt these together in approximately 3 to 4 hours.
Okay, so the folks that are here at this show are here because it's a sustainability show. So I'd like to ask you, how do you consider this particular structure to fit into the lifestyle of folks that are looking for sustainability?
Well, the structure is designed for greenhouses, and right now with the price of produce and everything, you could grow your own vegetables in this. We have an aquaponics system in this one. It's a complete system with fish and plants and a whole system that can produce food. And the greenhouse aspect is to protect the plants, the temperature, the environment of the plants and the fish.
So you can get a total enclosure here to where everything inside is protected from the elements outdoors. Is that correct?
Exactly. And being a strong structure that it is too, it can withstand high winds. It can be put up, like I said, very, very easily and taken down also.
Well, as you well know, today we're getting an unusual snow event. Tell me about this structure in the snow. How would it hold up in a heavy, wet snowstorm?
Well, we've had it engineered, and this structure will hold 30 pounds per square foot and will sustain 100 mile per hour winds.
Wow, that is incredible. Okay, so let's say it's exceptionally cold in January, where you can have below zero temperatures here in Colorado. What's it going to be like on the inside?
If it's a sunny day, it'll heat up real easily with the passive solar. You would need supplemental heat if you were going to grow year-round, but it wouldn't require much.
Okay, well, speaking of year-round, the thing that comes to mind in Colorado is the sun shines over 300 days a year here, as everyone well knows. How can you capture that energy for your dome and make it usable?
Well, you've got solar panels. We can use solar panels to collect energy. We can cool it with the energy produced by the solar panels. And we can also use evaporative coolers to keep more humidity in there for the plants.
And obviously the passive solar sunlight is doing the plants, the fish.
Everything loves it.
All good for all living things. So Dave, what would you say some other uses of this dome would be?
There you go, there's a list. Greenhouse.
Are you serious? A sunroom, a solarium?
Yes.
An artist studio, a concession stand, a man cave, an artist studio for the ladies, a craft room, disaster relief shelters,
that was key.
A golf storm shelter, I never thought of that for a golf course, a storage shed, an ice fishing hut, this can be put up in 3 hours?
Oh yeah, this size, 16 footer in about an hour and a half.
Well, I think we've thought of everything, unless you can think of something else, but I will tell you this, I feel very peaceful and serene with that fountain in the background.
Well, on a snowy day like today, what I would want to do is sit in my hot tub and relax and chill out.
We'd like to thank you for coming out to Dome Creations today. Have a great day.
Visit us at domecreationsonline.com. Or contact Dave Falasco, president and owner of Dome Creations, 719-502-5519.